So methylphenidate is actually an old drug that's been used to treat attention deficit disorder in kids for many, many years. But it's been known for a long time that some of the functions that the drug has is to work on a neurochemical called dopamine. And from studies that we've done and others, there is evidence that dopamine is lacking in the brains of individuals with Alzheimer's disease, and that dopamine lack may cause apathy or lack of motivation. So by increasing the amount of dopamine in the brain through this drug called methylphenidate, we had hoped to improve symptoms of apathy that are associated with the illness. So in general, we found that people had a little bit more energy, a little bit more of spark. They were more willing to communicate. They seemed more interested in things, more willing to participate in activities. So overall, it seemed to improve all the symptoms that we typically associate with apathy or amotivation in people with dementia.
Well, apathy can be most succinctly described as just a lack of motivation. And you might think compared to aggression or something, a behavior like that that happens with Alzheimer's disease, it wouldn't really be a problem. But it is, because these people only have a certain length of time left where they have the cognitive ability to do these activities and interact with their family. And really, they're just sitting around, so they're not living up to their cognitive ability. So it's very sad. They can also have emotional withdrawal from their loved ones as part of their apathy syndrome. And they tend not to do their self-care when they still have the ability. So they sit around and they might just want to sit in a darkened room all day and not do anything. So it's very sad and very distressing for the caregivers. And in fact, it is, along with aggression, one of the number one causes for being institutionalized. If you ask these patients what they've done today, they tell you that they got up at 6 a.m., they went for a swim, and then they went for their usual walk and all the things they did. And you ask the caregiver and they say, they haven't actually done that in years. They just sat there. So there's also a lack of insight that goes along with it, which makes it difficult to treat. The results of this study are important because caregivers and patients who have apathy are both suffering with it. And as we stand now, there is no cure for Alzheimer's disease, and there were no good treatments for apathy. So we're hoping we can improve quality of life in people who have Alzheimer's disease by having another medication that they might be able to try. Well, our new medication, of course, is not a cure for Alzheimer's disease. There is no cure for Alzheimer's disease. What we're hoping instead is to improve quality of life in people with mild to moderate Alzheimer's disease, so that instead of sitting around and suffering from apathy, they may be able to engage in their normal activities of daily living and interact more with their loved ones.